to me thou art honest. Now, if thou wert a poet, I might have some hope thou didst feign.
Would you not have me honest?
No, truly, unless thou wert hard favored, for honesty coupled to beauty is to have honey as sauce to sugar.
A material fool.
Well, I'm not fair, and therefore I pray to God make me honest.
Truly, and to cast away honesty upon a foul slut, or to put good meat in an unclean dish.
I am not a slut, though I thank the gods that I am foul.
Well, praise be the gods for thy foulness, and sluttishness may come hereafter. But be it as it be, I will marry thee. And to that end, I have been with Lady Margaret Martex of the Vicar of the next village, who hath promised to meet us in this place of the forest and to couple us.
I would fain see this meeting.
Oh, the gods give us joy!
Amen. A man may, if he were of a fearful heart, stagger in this attempt. But here we have no temple but the wood, no assembly but horned beasts. But what the... Ah! Sir Lady Margaret! Lady Margaret Martex! Oh, you are well met. Will you dispatch us here under this tree? Or should we follow you to your chapel?
Is there none here to give the woman?
I will not take her of a gift of anything.
Truly, she must be given, or the marriage is not lawful.
Proceed, proceed. I'll give her.
Good evening, good monsieur, or what you call it. How do you do, sir? You are very well met. Good ill you for your last company. I'm very glad to see you. Even a toy in hand, sir. Nay. Pray be covered.
Will you be married, Motley?
As the ox hath his bow, sir, the horse his cur, and this falcon her bell. So man hath his desires, and as pigeon filled, so my luck be nibbled.
And will you, being a lady of your breeding, be married under a bush like a beggar? Get you to church, and have a good priest that can tell me what marriage is. This lady will but join you together as they join the way in Scots. Then one of you will prove a shrunk panel and